Hey, it's Lori Ballen out here in Las Vegas, Nevada with understandcommand.com. This video is part of my 365 days of KW Command, where I'm bringing you bite-sized tutorials and full-on core lessons to help you better learn command. I am doing this just as an independent agent who has a team and also uses KW Command, and I'm a trainer for my own brands. So today what we're going to do is there's a question that keeps coming up in all of the groups, and it's, hey, I got this many clicks on my ads and no leads, how come? So that's what I want to talk about specifically today. All right, so what we're going to do is I'm going to go over here to paid ads. So I'm in campaigns on the left hand side. This little megaphone is how we get to campaigns, and campaigns is where we run our paid ads. So I've got Facebook ads, I've got Google ads, I've got Twitter ads, I've got Instagram ads. And most of you, I'm seeing this question come up with where it comes to Facebook, but I kind of also want to address it as an overall. All right, so what you see up here in your dashboard, for example, where you see the little G, these are Google ads that are being run. The F is Facebook ads, and if I expand on those, I'll see Instagram and Twitter as well. Now, what we can see if we scroll over that everybody's really looking at is number of clicks and number of leads. So let me open one of my Facebook ads. Okay, let's do this one right here. All right, so if you look here without me even opening the ad, what you can see is it was run on Facebook, and I had 832 impressions. That's how many times the ad was shown, 832 times. Total number of clicks, 66. So that could be 66 people clicking it, or some people clicking it multiple times even. So 66 clicks total, not necessarily 66 unique users. And then I got 10 leads, okay? Now, right above that, we see another ad that was run on Facebook, same amount of time frame, totally different ad spend, obviously, but 62 clicks again, very close to this one, and zero leads. Well, why would that be? The reason why is because of the type of ad we're running, how we're capturing that lead, or where we're sending them. So if I open this one on observation here, let me do it. Let's see. Can't open that one. Let's do this one on Blue Peak. So Blue Peak had 96 clicks and 14 leads. So let's look at that one and find out, okay, why was that one working? Why did we actually get leads? Okay, so this one ran on Facebook, it ran on Instagram, and it ran on Twitter. And if you'll notice that the leads came from Facebook and Twitter, I mean Facebook and Instagram, but there's no leads on Twitter. Again, it's because of where we're sending them when we run the ad. So let me see if this one, if I have to start a new one or if this will let me open the details. Let me get back into Facebook for a second. There it is. Okay. So now you can see, I want you to see what the ad looked like. Okay. So we'll look at what it looked like in mobile. All right. Beautiful, rare, fine, meticulous, maintained, 2,022 square foot home, yada, yada. Okay. Now, let's see if we can. Nope, can't open it all the way. All right, so let me do it this way. I'm going to go to create a new campaign, and I'll show you exactly where you're having an issue. So I'm going to click on, we want to run a paid ad. So we're going to do a social ad. See where it says paid underneath there. And I'm just going to call this sample lesson. We're advertising a listing, and we're going to run it on Facebook. Okay. Actually, I'm going to put all three so you can see. Set up campaign. All right. So let's just say you pulled any address. I'm just going to pull anything here. All right. Let's just say we're running this one here. All right. Where you run into an issue, your ad copy's probably fine, your headline's probably fine, your picture's probably fine because you're getting the clicks. The problem isn't that people aren't interested in your ad if you're getting clicks. The problem is they're not becoming leads, and we have to find out why that is. So if we go down here to Facebook and Instagram ads, click that to open. This is where the difference is. Right here, if you say destination, use a site or a landing page, and you send them either to a landing page you built on your website, or you're sending them to any other destination URL that doesn't have instant lead capture, you don't get leads. Where if we choose Facebook lead generation form, oh, I'd have to go up there and choose the page. If we choose lead generation form, then what happens is the person automatically, when they click your lead, has to click your ad, has to register to become a lead. And their data is actually pulled in right from their Facebook profile. So it's a no-brainer. They don't have to do much. And then they click through, and then they wind up on your listing page. So it is forcing them to become a lead in order to get the information. So if you're sending them to a page that already gives them the information, that could be a reason why you're not getting leads. Now, you'll see that exact thing where it comes to Twitter, because Twitter doesn't have a lead capture option. You can only send them to the direct page and nobody becomes the lead because they just click through, they look at the property information. If it's not what they want, they bounce. You have to have lead capture when you're running paid ads, if your goal is leads. If your goal is traffic or your goal is just brand awareness, then you're spending money to get the brand awareness and get the interest in the property. But if your goal is to get leads, you must use some sort of forced lead capture that has them register before they get the item that they want. That's what's happening in most cases. The other thing could be that you're just running an ad that people are randomly clicking on, but there's nothing of interest there for them to click through. That would be strange if they're clicking on it, though. There must be some level of interest. So I would have to look a little bit further. Now, what I would tell you is if that is happening in your case, put a comment below on the YouTube channel. And what I would want to do is see a copy of your ad you're running and where you're sending them to. So I might have to have you email that to me in order to address it. But go ahead and put a comment in the below on the YouTube channel and just tell me what type of ad you were running and where you were sending them. So if you're running a Facebook lead ad, you're forcing the lead ad form. That's the one up here. You're forcing right here. Use Facebook lead generation form. Go back and check your ad. And make sure it's that first button. If that's where you're sending them and you're getting all those clicks and no leads, I'd be curious what your ad looks like because there might be just something being missed in there because that should not be happening. So far, what most of us have been finding is that we're getting leads. If we run an ad for a listing, we're getting them for less than a couple bucks a lead. Okay, so that's something to keep in mind. Now, when I'm running, let me go back for a second. When I'm running ads that are not specific listing ads, so they're ads like see all homes that were just reduced or see all homes in the Summerlin neighborhood or that type of thing, then we're not seeing quite as many leads. So here's one, just reduced. Okay, is this the cost per lead? Here we go. Just reduced. This is an ad I'm running and I got 9 leads for $2 a lead, 222. Now this one was actually a listing ad and it was 286. This one was 296. This one was a $1.25. This one was a $1.36. This one's 375. That ad obviously just kind of failed. I changed up the image and did it again, and you can see up here I got a much better cost per lead. All right. So kind of a general idea. There's one for $2. So around a couple dollars, around a couple dollars. When I run a listing that's what I call a bread and butter listing, which means it's right at our average price range or right below our average price range, I get a lot more leads. My cost per lead is lower. Just letting you know, the higher price the listing goes, the more I end up spending on the cost per lead. So just not as many people wanting to click through and register for a $500,000 house. But in Vegas, everybody wants to register for a $250,000 house. You know, that's just kind of how the rule of thumb. All right. So I'm going to be bringing you another video that has a little bit more of the math on what you can expect to see. But hopefully this just gives you some quick guidelines without us doing a whole bunch of math on the fact that if you run a listing ad on Facebook and it's a Facebook lead form ad, you should be able to get your leads from anywhere from $1 to $3 a click, let's just say. And if you're not, then there might be something going on there that needs to be looked at. All right. Thanks for watching this video. I'm Lori Ballen in Las Vegas, Nevada.